Hi there, I'm Aparna, your personal coach, helping you upskill yourself to lead the life you desire. Last week, I had the privilege of speaking to two wonderful women who have moved out of their comfort zone and discovered the magic outside of it. Today, I've spoken to men who have done it. It is difficult for men to actually take this decision unless you're really, really passionate about going after the life that you want. Men who are bold, who are courageous, and have enough guts to pursue their passions. And I'm privileged to be presenting these men to you. So let's get on with the Q&A.
So for us, it was a very strong interest, a very strong passion towards farming. So we had this farm, a 21-acre farm, and we had been seeing it from childhood. We had sugarcane as a main crop at the farm, and the productivity of which was declining each year. So if it was 80 tons when we were kind of small, when we were looking at it, it was dropping down from 80 to 60 to 50 tons per acre. And it was a natural interest as to why is the productivity dropping. That got us to an understanding that as a farmer, the main soil, you know, the soil is main that you're farming on. So irrespective of which crop you're growing, it is the soil that is the main medium.
Right.
So it was one small interest that led to the other, and eventually it was so intellectually engrossing, the questions, nature, soil, animals, microorganisms, all of this was so interesting that we finally got into doing it full time.
Okay, that's amazing. So it's more like a passion for farming.
Correct. It was an interest where one thing led to the other. One question led to more deeper questions and more R&D happening.
Okay.
So we visited a lot of farmers around Maharashtra, around Gujarat, around Karnataka. We saw a lot of farms. We saw farms that were chemically being done, organically farming, where it was happening. So, like I said, one thing led to the other, and then we were into it full time. So even if you're doing our jobs, you're thinking of what's happening at the farm, what are the crops of the farm, how are they behaving, any insect attack on them, any pest attack on them. So it was 24/7 thinking only about farming, soil, and crops.
Age of 18 till age of 23, 24, I was doing a lot of singing. I lost my voice, just overuse of vocals.
Okay.
And you get notes. And I thought my career is over, and I was pretty much depressed about it. And I said, no, I need to do something.
Okay.
Picked up a guitar. And meanwhile, I started playing a little bit of drums also. I did my master's degree, but I was into sales. Shitty job. Not so creative. Actually, not creative at all. First 2 months is fun, but later on it's so boring. I was wasting my 8 hours to 10 hours.
Yeah.
At the age of 30, I said, enough is enough. I'm wasting my time, I'm wasting my life. This is not what I want to do. Lot of people have to do it because they don't have choice. I had a choice. I said, I'm going to quit.
Right.
So one day I just said, enough is enough. Packed my bag, no job henceforth.
For us, for the first 4 years, we were unprofitable. We went to straight losses for the first 4 years continuously, until when we could tweak things at the farm, understand things better, and then start making this venture into a profitable venture. So yeah, apart from the social stigma and all associated with it, there are practical problems. Like as a farmer, when you're selling your stuff to the local mandi, which is the only market available, it is not easy to make money. Most times even expenses don't come out. So there were practical problems. Especially with marketing to get into farming, and there was also a social stigma around it to get into farming.
I was just staying at home, practicing, nothing else. And when you start doing things 24/7, you get some results. You get better at it. You get results, and you know it. The graph is growing also, and you know you're getting better and better. See, there is nothing like best. There's a scope of improvement when it comes to art, and it's that's what challenges me. Things shouldn't be easy in life. That's what I feel. There should be some pain in life if you want to go on the next level. And that happened with music. playing music is not an easy thing. Or doing any art is not an easy thing. Mm. To go on the next level, you have to spend X amount of hours. If you don't do that, you will never go on the other, next level.
Right.
So I kept doing it, and then I found myself growing up musically. Meanwhile, I was playing with other bands also. Mm-hmm. I did about a couple of albums also.
Yeah.
Then I got into teaching, because I got one job wherein which I used to go to schools, mm-hmm. and I used to teach them music appreciation. So I used to teach them sometimes mm-hmm. singing or maybe some rhythmic mm-hmm. exercises or something. Mm-hmm. And I did that for almost a year. And then a lot of students used to come to me and they used to ask me whether do you teach guitar mm-hmm. or something. So okay, if people are asking me, yeah. let me try. Let's yeah. get into that also. We started two students, two became four became 10, 10 became 40, and you know. And then I thought, I think I have a flair of teaching. People yes. are enjoying whatever I do.
Right.
We were brought up in a school in Pune. We were farmers' children, but our father put us in a good school, in a boarding school in Pune. Mm. From there, we did an MBA. The next natural progression was to do, was to do a job after doing an MBA.
Right.
Now, for my father, for people at the farm, you know, coming back from a city to a farm, to farming, was not evolvement. It was kind of devolving.
Yeah.
So, in a way, it was not accepted, not the right thing to do.
Mm.
So it took us some time. So right from when the idea seeded in us that we should do this full time, there was some hindrance, there was some challenge, there was a lot of social stigma associated with farming, and it was a challenge in itself because honestly, farming is not very profitable. Yes, so especially people at home were not happy,
okay.
Dad in particular, so that was expected. So we had quit our jobs, got into farming. They had done farming all their lives. They had seen it not being profitable, not a very green venture. So there were a lot of people who were speaking, who were telling us, negative reactions.
Mm.
Don't get into this, you'll have a good job, continue doing it.
Okay.
But probably the questions we had at the farm, the kind of interest we had when we went in the farm, on the soil, the intellectual curiosity was so high in doing farming and getting the model right, that the questions within farming were so loud that we couldn't hear what people are saying. No, we had our own inner voices questions related to farming, questions related to soil. So probably that's why we never had the energy to to pay attention to what people are saying, because all our energies were absorbed in understanding the farm and understanding the farming.
How the Indian family works.
Yes.
They don't, this is not an important thing.
Good.
Music over there was secondary.
Yes. Yes.
So they never supported me what I wanted to do. They wanted me to take up a job, settle down in life. I don't know how you define settle down.
Yeah, exactly.
It's the most difficult thing. In this entire process, there was no support. There was only support from my friends.
Okay.
Family.
So people who are part of your band?
Band and friends. Yeah. Band and friends.
Mm-hmm.
And this.
Now, super. Nothing like farming. Absolutely loving it. Each day is a treat in itself. We wake up in the morning, get to the farm, our churning of the curds, we make ghee. So it starts at 4 a.m. in the morning and it gets over before 7 a.m.
Okay.
So we make desi cow ghee by the churning process.
Okay.
Once,
the proper.
Correct.
Okay.
So wood fired milk, the milk is boiled on wood fire. And then it's converted into curd and then churned by hand.
Mm.
So this, once the sun rises, we stop churning it.
Oh.
So from morning 4 a.m. to 7 a.m. So you're asking about the day. So our day literally starts in the morning at around 4 a.m.
Mm.
And wonderful. Nothing like having the soil below your feet, the sky above your head, no office like that. With the crops, with the animal.
Awesome.
We just love it.
Awesome.
I'm a happy person. Because a lot of peace of mind is there. I do, I enjoy what I do.
Yes.
And one thing about this is it's never ending.
Mm.
So I'm learning all my life.
Good.
I'm practicing. Whenever I get time, I'm just practicing. And since I play 4-5 instrument, I need to keep in touch with
them. Yes.
But whatever I'm doing, I am enjoying.
Yes. That's more important.
That's more important.
Yes. Okay.
So when we started off, like I said, we had this interest, but there's always a level of unpredictability always a level of, you know, you're getting to an unknown unknown field. For us, the marketing part of it, we never knew how this model would make money.
Right.
When we got into it, it was purely getting into it for the love of farming, for the love of soil.
Right.
So for the first year, we understood, you know, it's not making money. Second year, we understood it's not making money. Third year, fourth year, fifth year, we got the model right. Okay. So for the first 4 years, it was about just doing what you love, trying to find a way through it, not knowing what would happen. But then after that, like you said, it was magic.
Yeah.
So somewhere, once you start following your instinct, once you start following your gut, then magic happens. Mm. But if you're looking at specifically at moving from a job to a business or moving from a job to farming, the shift is also, it also happens if you leave yourself no other plan. Like for example, when we quit our jobs and got into farming, we were very clear that, you know, let's burn all bridges. No matter what happens, if this would have not have been profitable for 5 years, 6 years, 7 years, we were clear that we've burned all bridges at getting back to the job, getting back to the city.
Yeah.
So we were 100% clear that, you know, if there is a way, the way is going to be out of here. Even if it's a drought situation, even if there is no market prices, even if the crop is gone for a failure, you know, natural challenges, market challenges. But we had burned bridges mentally, right? You know, no getting back to any other thing. Whatever happens will happen from here through here.
Okay.
So the magic will happen if you leave yourself no other plan B. This is the only thing that you know you're going to be doing. So it again boils down to how interested, how passionate you are about doing whatever that you choose to do.
Right.
I think if that is very loud, everything else is secondary. Even finance is a secondary, what people say is secondary, you know, the unpredictability factor. What will happen? How will I get out of this? How will I make money out of this? Even that becomes a secondary question. If your passion, if your interest is very strong, whichever field it be.
Basically, you'll get hired. As an art form is like, you don't get things pretty easy. You need to really work towards it. And magic is like, you know, when you get one certain, for example, you're doing one exercise. It takes a lot of time. And the moment you're comfortable with that particular thing, it's, oh man, it's a different high.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean that's right. There is nothing like this is right. There's a scope of improvement for everything. So you work towards it.
Excellent.
And it's more fun doing that. Because like for Sarigama Padanesa, you can sing in many ways.
Yeah.
So your emotions matters or not.
Yes.
So more you do, more better for you.
So should I say you have to be 100%
involved? 100%. If you're not involved, then you won't go to the next level.
Right.
Then you go back to job only.
Yeah, actually, yes.
Hi, my name is Ajinkya. I am a farmer and we run this farm called Two Brothers Organic Farms. I left my job, I left my comfort zone around August 2012 and doing farming ever since. My message, you know, to anybody out there who's looking to quit his job, to get into his interest area, my message would be, you know, do it. If you have arrived at an interest, if you've arrived at a passion in life, you know, that arriving itself is a very big message. So, you know, close your eyes, do it. Of course, it is going to be challenging, it's not going to be easy. But make sure you left yourself with no other plan. What worked for us is, we had left ourselves no other plan B. So we had burned all bridges to doing what we're doing today. Which is why, in spite of 4 years of losses in the first four initial years, we could see ourselves through. So be very clear, burn all your bridges, get down to doing what you really want to do, whatever interests you, whatever you're passionate about, and enjoy the unfolding.
Okay, hi, this is Sanjeev. I'm a musician. It's been 20 years. I'm doing what I like to do in life. It's fun, a lot of pain, but I guess in the end it's pleasure. Yes. People who wants to do full time, to follow their passion or something, they should at least try once, jump into it. At least try for 2 years. If you can't do what you like to do or don't get successful, what you're doing, you can get back to the job. But give those 2 years sincerely for your hobby or passion. Cheers.
Like I said before, it takes a lot of courage to pursue what you really, really want, what your heart desires, and not give in to the societal pressures. Societal pressures, financial pressures, they continue to be there. But the moment you take a decision to find what your true calling is, I think you need to stick to it. And like these men said, all you need is to find your own passion. All you need is to take that first step into the direction to discover your magic. I hope you find this video resourceful and motivating enough that you step out of your comfort zone. I'd love to hear your feedback. Do give it in the comment section below or reach out to me in any of the social media platforms I'm on. And of course, as usual, if you like this video, do give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Subscribe and also hit the bell button so you'll never miss an update from me. Thank you so much. Thank you so very much for watching. I'll see you next week.